The match report from last night's playoff win against Folkestone Invicta is now online. The report from David Ballheimer can be found here. Posted at 18:05, the highlights of last night's win are now online courtesy of the Bostik League show from the back of the net team. The 40-minute show also includes highlights from Dulwich, so if you only want to see our highlights, scroll through to about 26 minutes. The coverage includes interviews with Gary McCann and Zach Joseph. It's well worth a watch, not just if you were unable to be there, but also if you were there and want to relive the game. The highlights can be found at https://www.youtube.com/watch?v=9vq2yet8 posted at 17:59. The admission prices for Monday's playoff final against Dulwich Hamlet are now available, together with online sales. Prices will be £10 adults, £5 concessions and free for under 13s. Concessions include those over 60, unemployed, members of the armed forces, NHS workers, those on disability living allowance and students, on production of appropriate ID. Online ticket sales are now up and running, and can be found by clicking here. It is not an all-ticket game, and the gates will open at Imperial Fields at 2 p.m. Please remember that the game is at Tooting. Posted at 12:06, the first team reached the playoff final this evening after beating Folkestone Invicta 4-0, with the awesome foursome of Ashley Nathaniel George, Josh Walker, Nico Muir and Zach Joseph each scoring in the first half. That first half saw the Greens play some of their best football of the season so far, and the opening goal came in the 6th minute when Walker was put through by a great ball from Muir to lift the ball over the keeper. 10 minutes later, it was Nathaniel George's turn to score after the ball was flicked on by Muir. 2 minutes before the break, Joseph intercepted a sloppy pass by the Folkestone defense and curled the ball into the net, and just a minute later Muir was put through and he netted clinically to score his 40th goal of the season, much to the delight of the Hendon support in the crowd of 722. The second half was more even in terms of possession, although the Greens looked more likely to score. Folkestone did hit the post with a header, but otherwise rarely tested Tom Lovelock, who was protected superbly by the other awesome foursome, the back four of James Hammond, Ryan Bray, Arthur Lee and Oliver Sprigg. All those, together with the tireless wear crate from Jake Eglinton and Casey McLaren, together with the three substitutes, Dave Didiu, Sam Murphy and Daniel Uchechi, ensured that the clean sheet was kept. With Dulwich Hamlet beating Leiston 1-0, the Greens will now travel to Tooting. Posted at 23:08, this is what you can expect in Hendon's match program against Folkestone tomorrow. Gary McCann, Gary looks forward to the playoffs, Greensview, Daz Floors program editorial, match reports, covering the Leatherhead and Leiston wins, the Greens in action, picks from our victory at Leiston 2015 playoffs, revising Hendon v Met Police and Margate, playoff results, annual Isthmian League Premier Division semi-final and final results, Hendon A to Z, an additional article by David Ballheimer, this one about youth team football, Hendon team photo, double page spread of Hendon's starting team which won at Leiston, head-to-head, Folkestone v Hendon League results, Barry Williams, David B's tribute to Hendon's former manager who passed away recently, our visitors, history and player profiles of the opposition, plus, HFC fixtures and results, supporters trust news, stats pages, including the final league table, HFC appearances and goals, attendances, leading Premier Division goal scorers programs on sale at SJP tomorrow or by subscription for PDF versions to Eddie Edwards on hendon.ed@hotmail.com posted at 12:29. We are anticipating our biggest attendance of the season on Thursday evening when we entertain Folkestone Invicta at SJP, and additional parking has been secured to ease pressure on the roads around the ground. The arrangements are the same as for the Billericay game in March, so the car park at SJP will be available as normal, but it expected to fill up much earlier. Folkestone have advised us to expect a team coach and a supporters coach, which of course we need to keep space for. With thanks to Barnet Council, a second car park has been made available once again at West Hendon playing fields. This holds around 100 cars and is just a 5-minute walk from the ground across West Hendon playing fields. As it will be dark after the game, stewards will be provided to ensure people going back to their cars are kept safe and don't get lost. The additional parking can be accessed in Goldsmith Avenue, which can be found opposite the West Hendon branch of Sainsbury's on the A5 Edgware Road. If traveling from Staples Corner, junction of M1, A406, A5, the turning is on the left just after Hendon Magistrates Court. If traveling from the Kingsbury, Collindale direction, the turning is the first right after Kingsbury Road. The postcode for the car park is NW97EX. There will be a steward on duty in the West Hendon car park who will direct you to the ground. We ask all supporters to be considerate to the residents in the surrounding streets, and ensure that driveways are not blocked or access inconvenienced by inconsiderate parking. Also, please do not park close to the entrance to the SJP car park, so that there is space to allow the coaches to enter and exit. In all cases, please follow any instructions given by our stewards, who will be working to maximize the number of vehicles into both car parks. Posted at 18:44, the match report from yesterday's win at Leicester is now online. The report from John Rogers can be found here. Posted at 20:52, the photos from the win at Leicester yesterday are now online. Dick Beach's photos can be found on Facebook and Flickr. Posted at 15:07, Thursday evening's playoff semi-final against Folkestone Invicta will be an all-pay game, and our normal admission prices will apply. Season tickets are not able to be used, and there will be no complimentary tickets available. Admission prices are £10 adults, £5 concessions, over 60, and students with valid NUS cards, and £1 for under 18s. Posted at 13:45, the kickoff time for Thursday's playoff semi-final against Folkestone Invicta will be at the slightly earlier time of 7:30 p.m. The reason for this is that we need to ensure that the floodlights at SJP are turned off by 10 p.m., and with the possibility of extra time and penalties being required, the earlier kickoff is necessary. Posted at 11:16, a last-gasp equaliser for Billericay against Folkestone, scored by Jamie O'Hara, ensured a third-place finish for the first team after they won 2-1 at Leicester. After a goalless first half, which the Greens had the better of, two goals in a minute from Ashley Nathaniel George and Daniel Uchechi just after the hour mark ensured that Leicester had to work hard to get something out of the game. But that's exactly what Leicester did, and they pulled a goal back through Joe Marsden a few minutes later, and Tom Lovelock made a superb save late in the game to ensure the lead was kept. With Folkestone only picking up a point, the Greens finish ahead of them in third place on goal difference. The playoff SEM final will be played at SJP on Thursday evening, kickoff at 7:45 p.m. Full details will be made available as soon as they're confirmed. Posted at 17:09, this afternoon's game saw Keegan Cole make his 100th appearance for the first team whilst still aged just 18. He is almost certainly the youngest player to achieve the milestone for the club. The young midfielder made his debut in a 2-0 win over Lewis in February 2016 and has scored 17 goals so far. Posted at 17:03, the match report from Wednesday's win at Leatherhead is now online. The report from David Ballheimer can be found here. Posted at 23:36, the under-18s finished their season this evening with a 4-1 win over leaders Camberley Town at SJP. On the score sheet were Diego Sotelo Series, Matt Forkin, 2, and Khalil Francis Onwaga. Posted at 22:46, now that we know we are in the playoffs, it's about time we confirmed on the website how they work. The semi-finals will take place on Thursday the 3rd of May, and will be 2nd v 5th and 3rd v 4th, with the games being played on the home ground of the higher-ranked team. Ties will be decided on the night. The final then takes place on Monday the 7th of May, and again takes place at the home ground of the higher-ranked team. As far as we are aware, any game involving Dulwich Hamlet as the home side will be played at Tooting. A win on Saturday, combined with Folkestone losing at Billericay, will mean that we would finish third, and be at home in the semi-finals. Finish fourth and we'll be away. Posted at 22:20, a late winner from Josh Walker secured a playoff spot this evening as the first team won 2-1 at fellow playoff hopefuls Leatherhead. Earlier in the game, Sam Murphy had scored his first goal since November 2015 to give the Greens an 11th-minute lead, which they held on to until Jack Midson, who had a loan spell with the Greens from Stevenage Borough in 2003, equalized around the hour mark. The Tanners put the Greens under plenty of pressure, but the defense held out, and were rewarded when Nico Muir forced an error from a defender, and the ball fell to Walker, who netted the winner. Posted at 22:16, Billericay Town secured the league title this evening as they beat Harlow Town 2-0 at New Lodge, whilst our playoff rivals and opponents on Saturday, Leicester, won 2-0 at Needham Market to draw level on points with us. In the other game tonight, Harrowborough won 4-0 at Dorking Wanderers. Next up in the playoff race is our game at Leatherhead tomorrow night, kickoff 7:45 p.m. at Fetcham Grove. Posted at 23:09, the under-18s were beaten 4-0 at Wealdstone this evening in their penultimate league match. Their final game is tomorrow evening when they entertain Camberley Town at Silver Jubilee Park, kickoff 7:30 p.m. posted at 23:06. The highlights from Saturday's win over Merstham, together with a post-match interview with Gary McCann, are now available through HFC TV. You can access the highlights by going to HFC TV in the other section of the website menu, or by clicking here. Posted at 18:23, we are delighted to announce that two testimonial matches have been awarded by the club, one to someone who has been a very important member of the playing squad for nearly 11 years, and one to be shared with two long-serving members of Gary's backroom staff. The player receiving a testimonial is Casey McLaren, who is our longest-serving player in the current squad, having joined us in the summer of 2007 from AFC Wimbledon, and injuries aside, has been a regular member of the side throughout his time with us so far. To date, he has made 355 appearances, scoring 51 goals, one of only two players to have broken the 350-appearance barrier since Simon Clark did so in 2002. The first member of the backroom staff is Gary's erstwhile assistant manager, Freddie Hyatt. Freddie has been back at the club since February 2006 when he took over from Andy Pape, and is a firm favorite at the club, just as he was during his three seasons as a player in the late 90s, when he made 163 appearances, scoring 18 goals. The second member of staff is our sports therapist Mark Findlay. Mark joined us in February 2007 from North Greenford United, taking over from Gary Anderson, whose later work included working with a GB bobsleigh team. Mark has played a very important role, not just helping players through injuries, but also ensuring that the team is kept in the best shape possible throughout the season. Dates and opponents will be announced in due course, and we hope that all supporters will recognize these three great club servants when the time comes. Dave Didi will complete 10 years with the club during the summer, having joined us from Willesden Constantine in pre-season 2008, and so, hopefully, we'll be able to make a similar announcement in 12 months' time. Dave, of course, is the only other player to have broken the 350-appearance barrier since Simon Clark. Supporters will remember we had a testimonial for Gary McCann a couple of years ago. Testimonials, like loyalties, in football have become much rarer in recent years, so to potentially award testimonials to five members of the playing our management staff in four seasons is something all of us at the club should be proud of. Posted at 17:11 following their 3-1 defeat at Kingstonian this evening, Staynestown are now out of the playoff race. They were forced to play central defender Ben Martin in goal this evening after regular keeper Connor Hudit suffered a broken bone in his hand over the weekend. Tomorrow night, the key game for the Greens is the Suffolk Derby between Leiston and Needham Market. Posted at 21:41, it is with sadness that we have learnt this evening of the passing of former manager Barry Williams, who was in charge of the club in the 1992-93 season before emigrating to Spain. Barry, who is best known for being the manager of Sutton United when they beat Coventry City in the FA Cup in 1989, also had a spell in charge of the England women's team in 1991. Our thoughts are with his family at this sad time. Posted at 21:17, we are pleased to announce that £150 has been raised in memory of Dermot Drummy through the bucket collection on Saturday afternoon and through online donations. Therefore, we will be donating £75 each to the Samaritans and to Mind in the next few days. Thank you to all those who made a donation in Dermot's memory. Posted at 17:22, David Ballheimer has assessed our current position, and ultimately we need just a point to secure a place in the playoffs. The various possibilities are as follows: two wins and Folkestone Invicta failing to beat Billericay Town in their finale, a Hendon finish third and entertain Folkestone in the playoff semi-final. Irrespective of all other results, if Folkestone beat Billericay at New Lodge, they will host Hendon in the playoff semi-final. One win and one draw, a Hendon are guaranteed fourth place and will be away to Folkestone. One win of the team Hendon defeat cannot overtake the Greens, and apart from a dramatic swing in goal difference, at least fourth place is assured. One draw, Hendon guaranteed to finish above the team with which they draw, and they will finish fourth or fifth. Finishing fifth would mean facing whoever finishes second, which seems set to be Dulwich Hamlet. Two defeats, a Hendon need other results to go their way to finish in the top five. Posted at 16:55, the photos and match report from yesterday's victory over Merstham are now online. Derek Beach's photos can be found on Facebook and Flickr. David Ballheimer's match report can be found here. Posted at 16:50, an excellent performance from the first team saw three more points secured in the race for the playoffs as Merstham were beaten 3-0. with Leiston and Leatherhead drawing 2-2, Margate losing 2-1 at home to Billericay Town and Staines Town only drawing 1-1 at Burgess Hill Town. We know that 4 points from the last two games secures a playoff spot. In fact, draws against Leatherhead on Wednesday and Leiston on Saturday will mean that it's impossible for both clubs to catch us, with Staines Town already unable to do so, and Margate needing to turn round a goal deficit of 11 to have any hope of overhauling us. The first goal came in the 11th minute, when Michael Corcoran finished from close range in a goal-mouth scramble as we took control of the game, with the visitors limited to half chances which Tom Lovelock was able to deal with a degree of comfort. Ashley Nathaniel George doubled the lead with his 14th goal of the season in the 64th minute, and just 2 minutes later Josh Walker extended the lead further with his 15th goal of the season. Third place is still not out of the question, with Folkestone having been beaten 3-0 by Dulwich Hamlet this afternoon. If we win both our remaining games, and Folkestone lose next Saturday at Billericay, we will finish the season in third place. It's a crucial week for everyone involved in the playoff, championship and relegation battles, and we'll aim to keep you updated day by day. The next game that affects us is on Tuesday evening, when Leiston hosts Needham Market. If you are able to get to Leatherhead and or Leiston, your support will be very important to the squad, and if you aren't able to get there, updates will be available through football web pages as usual. Posted at 21-11, our under-18 side had a big 5-0 win at Aldershot Town last night as they head towards the end of their season. The scorers were James Reptice, Diego Sotelo Series, Ricardo Alexander Greenaway, Giovanni Morgan and Khalil Francis Onwaga. Malachi McGovern picked up assists for 4 of the goals. They have 2 games left to play, on Tuesday evening at Wealdstone, and on Wednesday evening at home to Camberley Town, to see if they can improve on their position in the table. Currently they lie in 5th place. Posted at 11:03, we have become aware that many supporters who watched Dermot Drummy play in the green. In addition to the charity bucket collection in aid of mental health charity Mind and the Samaritans, anyone that is unable to attend tomorrow's match but would like to make a donation is able to do so via online bank transfer to the following bank. Details, account name, Hendon Football Club Supporters Trust Sort Code 089299 Account Number 65195222 Payment Reference Dermot The collection at the game will be taken at full time, and the buckets will be in position near the exit gate into the car park. Posted at 1936 Max McCann, who is a former player and of course one of Gary's sons, is running the London Marathon on Saturday to raise money in support of Bowel Cancer UK in memory of his uncle, Gary's brother, Lee, who died in January 2016 of the illness aged just 38. All donations, however big or small, will be greatly appreciated by Max and the family and will go to the research, support and care involved with the charity. We wish Max good luck with his run on Sunday, and if you happen to be watching the marathon, look out for him. The link to make a donation is available by clicking here posted at 12:13. Don't forget that our final home game of the season against Merstham kicks off at the earlier time of 2:30 p.m. on Saturday afternoon. This will hopefully enable everyone to avoid the worst of the Wembley traffic heading to the FA Cup semi-final. Posted at 21.